Good evening. There's been an explosion of fury and fear on the streets across the United States. Tens of thousands of people condemning the Supreme Court's decision to overturn a landmark ruling on abortion rights. President Joe Biden has called it a sad day for the country, while states have already begun rolling out new draconian rules that will shape the lives of millions of people.
A landmark ruling with repercussions for generations. Abortion rights law Roe v. Wade overturned after nearly 50 years, sparking protests and celebrations from the steps of the Supreme Court to the streets of New York City, Los Angeles and Dallas.
We don't care if people die.
Thousands voicing their anger. In the nation's capital, demonstrators burned a symbol of democracy and freedom, driving people to violence, a truck ploughing through pro-choice protesters in Iowa.
It's a sad day for the court and for the country.
President Joe Biden slamming the court for taking America back 150 years.
Let's be very clear. The health and life of women in this nation are now at risk.
The ruling gives states the power to decide their own laws, with half the country, 26 states, expected to ban or severely restrict abortions. 13 of those will move to do so within the next 30 days, while 6 states ceased abortions today, effective immediately. Arkansas was one of the first to change the law and one of half a dozen states that make no exemptions for rape or incest.
I can't wait for other women across Arkansas to have that same joy of seeing their child's face that maybe they would not have seen.
We did it!
Pro-life campaigners taking to the streets to celebrate.
I've been fighting my whole adult life, 4 decades, for this day. And it's one day, one victory. It's like taking Normandy Beach.
Republicans hailing a long-fought win.
Americans celebrate this historic victory because we know it will save the lives of millions of children and it will give families hope.
And applauding Donald Trump for appointing 3 conservative justices to stack the nation's highest court. The former president today taking credit for what he called the biggest win for life in a generation. And his conservative court appointments, it was my great honour to do so.
6 extremists on the United States Supreme Court have decided that they can force all of America to bend to their personal religious and moral views.
Women are going to control their bodies no matter how they try and stop us. The hell with the Supreme Court.
It makes me worried about the future of like my kids and like generations down the line.
For American women, their reproductive rights now come down to geography, but also class and race. Statistics show that those most affected by restrictive abortion laws are poor and women of color.
At this Mississippi abortion clinic, the care they once provided will now be a criminal offence.
These women in here right this moment are murdering their babies by the Constitution.
Healthcare centres across red states forced to turn people away.
I had a couple of staff members in here when the decision came in, and we could have took a moment to be together.
20 Democratic states will protect abortion rights.
Because in California, we refuse to turn back the clock and let radical ideologies exert control over your body.
A decision denounced around the world.
I've got to tell you, I think it's a big step backwards.
An attack on women's freedom, and quite frankly, it's an attack on everyone's freedoms and rights.
You know, restricting access to abortion does not prevent people from seeking abortion. It only makes it more deadly.
For all the condemnation and protests, not even the president has the power to rewrite history.
This is not over.
In Washington, D.C., Alison Petrowski, 9 News.
9's U.S. correspondent Alison Petrowski is outside the U.S. Supreme Court. Alison, this is a radical shift in the way America views human rights.
Yeah, it is, Georgie. Millions of American women going to bed tonight with less rights than they woke up with. America banning abortion before they ban assault weapons. Look, we've seen thousands of protesters out and about today, and we'll see thousands more right around the country tomorrow. But where their voice matters most is at the ballot box at the upcoming midterm elections, where the Democrats need to hold power in Congress. Abortion has always been a political issue, but it is also a deeply personal one.
Norma McCorvey, known in the landmark case as Jane Roe, defending the decision bearing her name and impacting all American women. The landmark 1973 ruling guaranteed the right to abortion.
The decision to end a pregnancy during the first 3 months belongs to the woman and her doctor, not the government.
And set the battle lines for a rapidly changing nation. Long despised in conservative states, the precedent survived 8 presidents until Donald Trump promised to transform the Supreme Court before the 2016 election.
Well, if we put another 2 or perhaps 3 justices on, that's really what's going to be, will happen. And that'll happen automatically, in my opinion, because I am putting pro-life justices on the court.
And he did. Neil Gorsuch in 2017, Brett Kavanaugh in 2018.
I don't live in a bubble. I understand. I live in the real world. I understand the importance of the issue.
And then, following the death of women's rights campaigner Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
This is something central to a woman's life, to her dignity.
Weeks out from the 2020 election, Amy Coney Barrett was sworn in, tipping the balance of the court even further to the right with assurances about existing law.
I, as a judge, have an obligation to respect and enforce only that law that the people themselves have embraced.
It was 3 justices named by 1 president, Donald Trump, who were the core of today's decision to upend the scales of justice and eliminate a fundamental right for women in this country.
Opening the door for other precedents to be re-examined.
There are now concerns about what this ruling might mean for other rights which aren't explicitly referenced in the Constitution, like same-sex marriage and access to birth control.
It's sad to see the political beliefs of individual justices use the Constitution against the people when it's not what they want.
For women facing the prospect of travelling for abortions, a number of companies have declared they'll cover transport costs for employees, and in some states, chilling consequences. Those who perform abortions could face life sentences.
We are in 2022. People should not have to desperately turn to unsafe methods to terminate a pregnancy.
Further dividing an already splintered nation. In the United States, Amelia Adams, 9 News.